Welcome to episode 83 of the Preferred Experience podcast. I'm Chris Lesueur, and today I'm going to share the topic of, I'm calling it slow down to improve. And a lot of times we feel like we got to do more and more to get better and fit in more things, run faster, work out more. All kinds of different things. We're all trying to, most of us are trying to really improve by doing more and more. But today I want to talk about slowing down and how it'll help you to improve. And we just started a new cycle at the gym this week. And there's four cycles that we'll be going through throughout the next year. And the first part of the first cycle of the four started on Monday this week. And each cycle is 13 weeks long. And this one's all about building a base. And so I was really thinking over what that all means and how it's going to help us. And it helped me to reflect on a lot of races that I've trained for over the years, doing Ironman races, doing Spartan races, doing SilFit events, all kinds of different things. And one of the biggest things I learned early on was from a coach of mine that I brought up before. And he helped train me for my first Ironman. And I thought, oh man, we're gonna be doing tons of work when I signed up with him for my first Ironman. And we did everything based off heart rate back then when I would train with him and different zones. And he told me he wanted me to not go above, at the time, like a 150 heart rate. Now that I'm 44, I would say that would be the equivalent of probably like a 140-ish heart rate, because it changes over time. And just based off feel from running for so many years and biking and doing all that, I've learned to really know what an aerobic base zone feels like. And so that's what I want to talk about today, is building a strong aerobic base and really improving in those areas. And so when I trained for this Ironman years ago, and Ironman, for those that don't know, I'm not just talking about a regular triathlon, I'm talking about a full distance Ironman. It was a 2.4 mile swim, 112 mile bike, and a 26.2 mile running marathon. And so when I started training with him, he was like, I don't want you to go over that zone two. And I was like, really? That sounds boring. And at the time, that was extremely slow for me and a little boring. And over time, as I did that, I was able to get to my race and really run an awesome race. For my first race, I was able to finish in 10 hours and 57 minutes, if I remember right. I might be off a minute or two on that. But my first full Ironman at Arizona here, all the way back in 2007, I was able to do that. And so I learned a lot by doing that, and it made a big difference. And so I recently have been really working on improving my running. This last couple of years, I kind of slowed down, probably from doing so much CrossFit, and which is okay. You know, I worked on improving in some different areas, and I feel way better than I've ever felt, having done CrossFit and running and some biking. But my running definitely slowed down, and I've really gained this desire lately to improve my running. And I was talking with a friend of mine, also he was a coach of mine in the last year, and he sent me a book called 80-20 Running, and that really brought back some memories. And this book's by Matt Fitzgerald, and he's been around in the running and triathlon world for years. He was writing books back when I had first started doing triathlons. And then on the cover page of it says, run stronger and race faster by training slower. So it was a great reminder that I need to start running a little slower. So I've been doing that lately, and it's making a difference. I've started to feel a lot better in those lower training zones. And today, as we were doing the workout at the gym, I found in CrossFit that this is just my thought. Maybe the reason people do CrossFit is because they don't enjoy running or biking. But it seems like whenever we have running or biking workouts or rowing workouts, people are like, oh man. But I enjoy those workouts. Those are the ones I look forward to versus the really strength-based workouts. So I enjoy those ones. But one of the things that really comes to mind that I've noticed is I think people really hate running because they're running too fast and they're just killing themselves. And the whole point of this new cycle that we're in is to slow it down a little bit, work on our running, build that base. So if you notice today, the first round on the workout was a 1500 meter row, and then a 1200 meter run, and then a 3 minute rest. And that 3 minute rest was there to help you recover, to slow down, and to be able to get ready for the next round. So we were able to go into that next round, hopefully rested, not winded. And I really tried as I was doing the workout to not really crush myself. I tried to hold a pace that I could hold the whole time, and it ended up finishing strong. I didn't make the time cap. I missed it by a minute and 20 seconds, but I finished it, and it was a great workout and had a lot of fun. But the two zones that we train in that I'm specifically gonna talk about today are aerobic and anaerobic. And aerobic's gonna be anything that is like sustainable, that if you're running with a friend, you could talk with them, or if you're running alone, you could sing the song that's on, but not just so winded. You're gonna be breathing a little harder than you would if you're walking. And sometimes for some people, an aerobic zone is walking. And so there's a way to figure all that out. But I like to just do it based off feel, and have found a lot of benefit doing that. You don't have to overcomplicate it. So I look at those two areas. So those are good things to look for when you're running. And then there are days, that we're gonna do anaerobic running. And we hit some of those at the track every Thursday at 5:15 a.m. We meet at the church across the street from the Williamsfield High School track, and we walk over and do a workout every Thursday. We get started by about 5:20-ish a.m. By the time we get over there. And we're done before 6:30 every Thursday. Great workout. We have a lot of fun people that show up, and I enjoy running with them every week. But we train different areas there. Sometimes we're gonna do more speed or shorter based anaerobic workouts, and then some days we're gonna do more aerobic based. But the cool thing about our running group is we do everything based off of where you're at. So the goal is not to necessarily keep with everyone else, but to run at a pace that you're able to hold and do great at. And we do that by figuring out your 1 mile PR time, and then we base all the workouts based off that. And the cool thing about being at the track is we're all together. So versus if we're running from the gym, a lot of times we get pretty separated, and it's really fun to be able to cheer each other on when we're at the track. So we have a lot of fun doing that. So we have that, and we're going to be keeping that going. We keep that going even through the winter. I always think maybe we should stop in the winter, but we always have a group that wants to keep it going. So it's been a really good thing for everyone that's done it. I've noticed lately, Richard that I train with in the 5 a.m. class, and when I'm at the track, he has really improved. And it's super cool to see how people improve. And he definitely has followed that training where he's running a little slower, and it's transferred on top of all the CrossFit that he's doing in here. So those are the main things. See where I was at here. So work on that base. By working on that base, you're gonna start to enjoy a lot of these workouts we do in here, especially during this cycle. Really focus on slowing down a little bit. We even do it with the lifts right now. On the snatch today, it was a lighter snatch that we could hold, and the whole point of it was to slow down. We set them down each time. There were five sets of three, and each time we were supposed to set them down and just kind of reset and then hit it with really good form and technique. And by doing that, by getting that form right and that technique right, as you start to tire, the whole goal is to be able to hold that form and technique strong, even when you tire. And by building that base, you're going to be able to really improve your experience in CrossFit and improve your performance in CrossFit. And I know that if you do that, you're going to have an awesome experience here. You're going to become stronger and do great. And that is all I have today on this topic. Don't forget to join us this next Monday at 7 p.m. for Tirsa and Megan's nutrition talk. Excited for them to share what they're sharing on that. I forgot to write down what it was, but they always have a great topic that they're teaching, and we'll have a replay of that this next Wednesday. Hope everyone's having a great week. Thanks for joining me today. Thanks for listening. Please work on those areas and subscribe to the podcast if you haven't been on it yet. We're on YouTube. We're on all the podcast channels, including Apple and Spotify. And we'd love to have you following that. Thanks again for joining me, and I will see you soon. Thanks a lot. We'll see you. Bye.